Garden, the Bastus Lateralis. I messed it up again, didn't I? Yep, I did it. I'm messing everything up. This is not the rectus femoris either. I'm such an idiot. Bastus medialis. There we go. Rectus femoris and vastus lateralis. Rectus femoris and vastus lateralis. Whatever. Lateralis. And now you can see that there's such a band going from one side to the other side. I'm not really sure how many of these muscles are actually useful to learn, but we're gonna try to learn a bunch of them. There's another muscle right here. And then there's a whole bunch of meth. I know this one's actually useful because it kind of ties to the rest of the crutch. And if you're going to leave off doing not safe for work art, then that's a useful one to remember. Alright, it helps define the shapes of the crutch. The abdominal muscle goes all the way down. See? Goes all the way down to the crunch. And then. And then. This one's right here. And there's one, two, three, four. There's one tiny one here, and a big one here. Hopefully, having learned what we learned from this thing. Then the arm. Biceps, triceps, brachialis. That's a new one that I didn't know even existed. Sort of thing you keep seeing over and over again, but you never learn it. Alright, the biceps are these two muscles here. They are two. They are two, remember that. They're not one, they are two muscles, and in really ripped ass people, you can see the division between the two. Alright, the brachialis. The brachialis is this one. Brach. Bicep. I mean, everyone knows the bicep, don't everyone know the bicep? And the triceps are these ones back here. And it's one, I think. It's just one. And then there's like a rope. A rope. Are we even going to use this? Where is she going to be holding on to that? Alright, we're gonna do it down here. We need a filter now, because we don't want to mess up everything else. Alright. We're gonna draw the arm, the other arm here. Brachialis is right here. Right here's the brachialis. But out of this one comes a bunch of other tiny little muscles. And here we got the brachioradialis. The brachioradialis. And there are one, two, three, that's a bunch of them. And wrists, no, this one's just one. This one, the brachioradialis, and that's one of the few muscles you can actually see in a person. It goes all the way from the upper arm to the forearm, and you can, it really stands out. You don't even have to flex. Now the wrist extensors, those don't really show up at all. I think they are most of the time completely hidden within your flesh. We're gonna try to fix this later. Muscle here, I think that matters, is the brachioradialis. Which is this one. This one goes right. You can even look at it in your own flesh, I think. And then humble hand, which if you are like me, you hate drawing. We draw the knuckles. I've always been bad, really bad at drawing hands, so if you want to ignore this part, feel free to go ahead. But if you don't, you want to be bad like me, you can try like this. We draw the knuckles and the tendons that go back as guides. All of this is gonna be one big guide. We're going to paint over all of this, and you don't always have to do it, but we're doing it so that you can learn how I do it. Since this is has a little bit of perspective, we're drawing it inwards. And here, the brachioradialis. The brachioradialis. Don't learn the muscles you already know. I mean, everybody knows where the biceps are, where the chest muscles are, where the shoulder are. Learn the muscles that you don't know where they are, because those are the ones that are gonna help you piece everything together. Unlike me, who hasn't learned them. We're gonna have to draw the brachialis is here. This one, the brachialis, is in between the biceps and the triceps, the brachialis. This is the ticket. This is the one we're gonna learn today. The brachialis and the brachioradialis. The two, and they make a team. They make a little team. You see how they're together? They merge here. And then it goes like a snake and curls all the way. It goes below the arm, I think it looks like. Maybe. I think it does. We're gonna have to look for more reference, because you see, here you can see the brachialis right here, and the brachioradialis right here. This goes all the way here, but I'm not sure if it comes, if it's this one and the other right here, can you see it? The other one is one of these ones, I think, but I'm not sure, probably not, probably it stays on the other side of the arm. Anyway, so far this is looking good, I think, It's good. Fancy. It's gonna be a shame when we start removing all of them. Here is a little band. A little band that separates all this. And what's it called? This little bone. Oh, we should do bone structure for the next one. It's gonna be fun. Because right now, we're only doing muscles. But what are muscles without any structure at all? They're nothing. They're nothing. Alright, here, we're gonna draw the wrist extensors. The brachioradialis again. Here's the brachioradialis with his friend, the brachia. The brachialis. The brachioradialis. One day I have to learn what this means, because that's probably would make it a lot easier. It probably means something like the muscle between the bicep and the triceps. Stupid Romans. Right, so the brachioradialis goes all the way here, I think, like a little snake. Remember, it's like a little snake. And then the extensor here, one extensor, this one's a big one, there should probably only be one. Next to the brachioradialis, there's another, no, I messed it up, I drew it wrong. This one's the brachioradialis. Brachioradialis, I think. Is that right? Brachioradialis. Brachioradialis. And then, next to that one is the brachialis. Sounds like a fish. Brachialis. It's here, right here. Almost here. With the biceps, which are two. And the muscle which joins right between the brachialis and the biceps. Alright, and the trapezius. The trapezius. We're going to detail the trapezius later today. We're going to detail the trapezius. One second, there's some messages. Look at all those cute little muscles. Ain't they precious? Alright, where were we? Extensor muscles. No, wrist extensors. Where is our buff man? Oh, this one's super good. This one's great. I'm gonna paste it. I'm gonna paste it here. Yeah. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. See? It's different. It's different everywhere. everywhere it's different. Everywhere it's different. One, two, three, four, five. All right, sounds like food's ready. So let's take a little break. One, two, six. So annoying. One, two, three, four. At least that one's consistent. It's one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. All right. All right, let's take a little break. We need to feed the belly. Alright. Thanks for watching. I'm gonna be back with this lesson after a short meal. Whoa, we have recorded 1 hour already. Alright. Bye bye. I'm gonna keep the stream online in case anyone stops by. Alright, let's keep going. Where were we? The hand. The wrist extensors. Let's see. We're gonna copy this here to make it easier on ourselves. What the heck is that player? Pay real close attention here. I wonder if it's actually possible to learn the exact positioning of this. Brachioralis. All right, let's not do that. Oh, COVID. All right. All right. Like this shape and then this shape. And this shape. There are a bunch of diamonds. I don't know what this shape is called. From the front at least, you try doing that here. It's kind of works still. You do it like this, and then like this, and then like this, and then like this, or is it, it breaks down there. That's where it breaks down. do it like this, then like this, then like this, then like this. Yeah, that's probably not gonna help anyone. Do it like this, then like this, like this, then like this, and then like this, and then like this, and then like this. Gonna have to design an armor for her, something that looks neat. I'm gonna rotate this like this so that it becomes easier to basically copy. Gonna make the horse look downwards, like it's maybe eating, looking for something in the ground. Alright, because instead of a car, we're gonna give her a cute little horsey. Cute little horsey, just like this one. Hey, little horsey. Horses are like big doggies, real cute. We can copy from this one the restraints. I never liked how that looks in a horse's mouth. I wonder if it's comfortable. It's probably not comfortable at all. A saddle? Yes, we do need a saddle. Gonna make the saddle right here. Make it a little thin, like in the reference picture. I think the most important thing at the end of the day is speed. And speed, unfortunately, only comes with practice. I think we need some music here. You're not gonna listen to it, but I will. Things light. It's getting cold. October weather. Halloween. Will soon be Halloween. Hope you all plan to wear some interesting costumes. I've always wanted to wear costumes on Halloween, but I'm too lazy and too cheap to buy one. Let's listen to some Shibayan records. It's gonna be good. Yeah, yeah. Alright, where were we? The straps. Alright, the straps. And one over here. Needs to follow the neck of the horsey. Wrap around. We should start drawing the other leg. Here right now, all I'm doing, not even worrying about which muscle is which, is just copying which one is the right one. Some ligaments, I think. Not sure what they're called. This white part, I think it's tendones, ligaments. Tendones for all those Spanish speakers. So there's another strap over here, and then it sort of does, there's a little bit extra strap. So you just draw a thing like here, and then the other end comes through here, and then it joins the strap that we drew over here. Just following this same shape. It goes over here, goes through her hand, then comes back around, then goes to the other hand, and then it should come over here. Let me red light it. Should be more helpful. Whoop. Oh. Whoop. You see the shape that it makes? So simple. But it looks complicated, but it's not. Just a very simple. And then it goes over here to the other end of the mouth. Alright, we're almost done. We're almost done! We can start painting soon. What's it called? Blanket wraps around the horsey. Now we could draw the muscles for the horse. We're not gonna do that, because if we did, we'd rather be dead. All right, this is the horse butt. The horse butt. Right behind everything. We might get away with drawing the tail. This is the tail of the horsey. Alright. Now we're gonna sketch a little bit of a background. We're gonna keep it simple, just like this. A little forest with a shiny sky. We could make it a creepy background, but we're not going to, because the original, as you can remember, is a happy and clear blue sky, shiny sun reflecting off her face. I'm thinking about what are the things I can record. I'm just making a bunch of Y shapes. That's probably not how you should draw forests, but that's all. That's as far as my knowledge of forest artistry goes right now. We're gonna do our best to make it look better later on. Let's get rid of the bearded back. There we go. We're gonna give her a badass sword right here. I've heard that this is impractical, that you should not wear your sword strapped to your back. But you know what? I don't care. Because it looks cool. I'm gonna draw it X-ray vision again. Make sure it's not digging into the poor horse's back butt. I'm gonna give it a sort of leather strap thingy, a little pommel. I'm gonna maybe do something more interesting later. Maybe give it a little wings or something. Like, is she a good knight or is she a bad knight? If she's a good knight, then there'll be angel wings, maybe feathers or something. If she's a bad knight, then there'll be bad wings or something like that. Maybe give it a little pointy edge here. Get another ring around the pommel. how many rings do you want? Do you want to make it look really complicated? Do you want to add some little details here and there? Sometimes something that helps is just drawing a bunch of gibberish and then giving it shape later on. But that if you do it too much, it kind of shows, and you don't want it. You want everything to look seamless and interesting. Horsey tail again. Alright. Now, here comes the fun part. Face muscles. It helps very often, and you'll see why when I start shading, to know where the center of each muscle is, because I might be wrong, but right now this is how I've been doing it. I basically use the center of each muscle to determine where most of the highlights should be. For example, the center of the eyelid muscle, the center of this muscle. It gets way more complicated with the face. The center of these two muscles. You want to give her a butt chin. The center of this muscle. Here, 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 here. Though with the face, you have to keep the highlights very subtle. Very subtle. As subtle as you can. But yeah. And some highlights merge into another, into others. How I kind of see it right now, and here you're looking at it sideways, it will be somewhere around here, the highlights. You then make them lines, they get simpler. I'm just making up stuff right now, so bear with me. Trying to figure out if there is a better way, a simpler way, without having to remember a billion frigging dots. Right. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Alright, ignore all of this. Let's do this. Let's draw her face muscles and see what happens. Alright, we still have to do the neck. We'll do it later, though. Uh-oh. It's got deleted some for some reason. Let me draw the nose. I wonder if these face muscles also have a bunch of complicated names. Let's find out. Yes, they do. Of course they do. No, I'm not gonna bother learning these ones, because screw that. Maybe later. You don't have to learn everything all at once. I mean, it's kind of obvious, but sometimes it feels that you have to learn everything together. What did I do? This is a mess. Stop it. Alright, there we go. I'm gonna make this one smaller. Let's look for a real face and see if we can find each one of these muscles in that face. Let's find a pretty face. Second, we need to find just the right face for this. Not photo washed. Try not for it not to be super photo washed. Alright. See, there's a highlight here. There's a highlight here, which corresponds to these two highlights. There's a highlight here, which corresponds to this highlight. Because it sort of makes a downward, inward slope right here, just before it rises again towards the tip of the nose. There's another highlight here, which is basically this. There's a highlight here, there's a highlight here. There's a tiny highlight here, which basically corresponds to these three. There's another highlight here. Because of the lighting, also be, you can also see it here, here, and here. There's another highlight here, because this part is the most prominently the one that stands out the most. Oh, what did I do? All right, here and here and here and here. Even the part that is in the shading, the shaded side of the face, both sides, even the light, the one that is in the light, and the one. That is shaded has highlights more or less in the same areas, because the, even though a part might be shaded, its new normal, so to speak, of lighting still follows more or less the same rules. The parts that should be highlighted are highlighted, the parts that are not highlighted are not highlighted. They're just in a lower threshold. Another highlight here, another highlight here, all these little highlights, the tips of the lips. But this is dark. Another highlight here, another highlight here. It's here, and it's here. Now this is a really tricky part. We'll go over it in detail later. Now it's not, doesn't look like it here, but I feel like these muscles that come right here sort of bump the flesh in these two points. Though I might be getting confused, and it's actually these tiny little parts right here over the lips. There's another highlight that corresponds. There is no muscle there. Interesting. I might just be making stuff up. this one's really cool. Look at this. And it's super cool. It's gonna be really helpful. Look at this fat. This is fat right here, I think. Whoever did this is awesome. You can see there's a highlight here right on the upper lip, and there's another tiny highlight here. There's three highlights. Oh, we're fucked up again. There's one highlight here, there's another highlight here, and there's another highlight here. And it's the same in this side. The chin, there's another highlight here, there's another highlight here, and here there is just the ever slightest change of tone. It's almost like she has no chin. Imagine if she had no chin like this. She was a horrible, horrible monster without a chin. What tells us that there is a chin is that the lighting slightly, very slightly changes. Look how there's a little shadow here, and it's highlighted down here, and then there's this almost the same tone, but then there's a shadow here. There's a highlight here, but it's shaded down here. Fascinating. Fascinating! Human bodies are weird. Anyway, let's go on. Where is our layer? There we go. All right. There are two tiny little muscles in the face, in the eyes. The one where the eyelashes are attached to, so very thin, and then the lower eyelid, I think. Once we're done with the face, we may call it a day before we move on to shading tomorrow. I said it's turned into a huge mess now. We can't see anything. Alright. We're going to do the front, the very front of the lip. Highlight the sides, little curves, but she's too happy now. No, the original, she was serious. We're gonna go for a more realistic look this time with the eyelashes, which tend to, I feel like, going across sort of shape that looks horrible. Let's try again. No, it goes more like this, I think. That looks a little bit better, still looks bad. You're gonna have to rework it again later on. Goes a little bit inward here too. Goes a little bit. There's a little ridge. Then the upper lip comes out, and here we're gonna follow the example of this other face. Interesting, interesting. Here I don't feel like the muscles are as helpful as with the body. As you can see, the highlights don't really follow all that much where the muscles are. This one's different too. Oh well, sometimes you just have to wing it. There is a muscle here, there is a muscle here, and here. But these two muscles, these things right here, this triangle right here and here, you can see it here. Ah, fuck. Gonna clean this up for the next session because it has reached a critical point. Too many refs, too many layers. It's this one, and here's the lip, a really fat lips, make it look cute, and then it goes down again. It goes down and then the chin comes up. Here it goes down and then the chin comes up. It goes down and then the chin comes up. Here the jaw, and it goes in a straight line. The two diagonal lines. Pretty obvious, huh? And it goes up. Here you can start to see the muscles. There's a muscle here, there's a muscle here. The two muscles that matter here the most are these two muscles. These two. If you get poked with a sharp thing in one of those, you're dead. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. Did we do it right? Yeah, we're getting better at this. 1, 2, 3. If you draw the muscles, in theory, it should help you because you're not going to add unnecessary things, or you're not going to miss some necessary things. It'll help you break down the image much more easily. It'll remind you where the highlights and the shadows need to be. Basically, just it'll take some extra effort at the beginning, but in the end it'll save you time and I think overall improve your work. Might need to make the head smaller, but we can do that later. One, two, three, four. One, wait a second. Yep. One, two, one, three, four. Did we do it right? 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here's a little hole. You have to put a little shade in there. Alright, since we went through all this trouble with the muscles and whatnot, we're probably going to try and give the armor we're going to give her a muscle motif. Gonna look cool. Their shape might look complicated, but it's not really that complicated. Look at some examples. Oops. At the end of the day, you kinda can make them look however you want. But there's one overall. If you stick to this rule, it's probably gonna look fine. The little earlobe, I think? No, the earlobe is something else. Little this, shadow for your ear cave. Another shadow. A Y shaped. This is a Y. Y. A weird circle. There's two Y's, I think. Highlight, 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 highlight. Alright. Draw a little hair. Alright, let's go. Let's keep going. know, the eyes themselves, there really isn't that much to them. Just make sure you make them really circlish. If they're looking at the camera, if they're angled, they change a little bit. It's like a flat circle in 3D space. Alright, you wanna start doing a little bit of shading? Might as well, just a little bit. Now we have a little bit of advantage with this one, cause we're going to use all of the colors we used before, for the most part. The jacket is going to be the armor. We're just gonna have to get a little bit rid of the background. Actually, let's outline her. Should make it easier to paint. There we go. Let's start packing some of these references so they don't get in the way. We're gonna put them all in a big folder. Big ref folder. Part of the work. We're gonna merge some layers. Start getting rid of stuff. Getting ready for the next step. Alright, are you guys ready for some line art? I hope you are. Testing, testing. Oh, Jesus, for a second I thought I wasn't recording. Almost gave myself a heart attack. Just going to do the outline, or maybe I'll do the whole line art. We create a clipping mask here so that the filter only affects her. Now let's get started. Now this is pretty straightforward, only time consuming when you do line art. You just have to try and use single strokes. Now my line art isn't anything to boast about. I do it pretty simple. Lately I've been trying to make some of the lines where, like I mentioned in the beginning, where there are edges, I make them thicker. I should be using a thicker brush. For example, all of this outline, all of this behind, I'm gonna try to make them thicker. But these lines, which are like here, like the lips, they're not edges, so I make them a bit thinner. Just a bit. Now we're gonna do something crazy when we start getting ready to color. Now I just realized I messed up. I messed up. Cause she's gonna be wearing an armor and I haven't drawn the armor yet. But we're just winging it, so we'll see how it goes. We'll see what happens. For example, here's a thicker line. This is the edge of the hair. Over her face and eyes. I don't know what I'm doing with the eyebrows. All right. Make that teardrop a little bit smaller. How small, you ask? I actually have no idea. Let's look at the rest again. Should be pretty small. Pretty small. Let's look at the real face. Yeah, it's pretty deep. It's pretty deep inside. I'm gonna try to make it the same here. It's pretty small, but pretty deep. This edge I added here, I think helps give some sort of depth. So this thing goes right inside. No one. Flat surface that looks upwards, goes into the eye, adding depth, and then there's this surface that goes down towards the lid. Now the eyelid, the lower eyelid is next, another flat surface going down the eye. Flat surface going down the eye. Another surface to a depth, but it's, we're looking down at her. This you will only be able to see it if you're looking up from below her nose. If the line of her perspective was somewhere, it'd be somewhere around here, I think. Supposed to be line art, well, it's not very good line art. Need some more music, 1 second. Her boobies now. Now that we know where everything else is behind, I think it's going to be a lot easier to place them. Now the cleavage, and this is something my brother taught me, should begin somewhere around here. For a ref. Alright, this one should work. See how it begins halfway across the chest muscles. Question is, maybe they are a little bit too big. There was another 1 second. A really good reference. I'm not gonna draw the nipples as much. I don't wanna get in trouble. I'm already paranoid that reference is so obscene. Vastus lateralis. I messed it up again, didn't I? Yep, I did it. I regret it. I'm messing everything up. This is not a rectus femoris either.
Such
an idiot. Vastus medialis. And with it, where they tend to meet, where lines make triangles.
There we go.
There is also a good rectus femoris to make them
in vastus
darker
laterals.
And thicker. Stand
rectus femoris. Vastus lateralis. Late whatever.
Lateralis.
You probably get to work. And now you can see that there's such a band going from one side
liner before I leave
to the other side.
I'm not really sure how many of these muscles are actually useful to learn. But we're gonna try to learn a bunch of them.
A whole bunch of mess. I know this one's actually useful because it kind of ties the rest of the crutch. And you're going to leave off doing not safe for work art.
Alright, looking
good,
I think.
A useful one to remember.
Alright,
it helps define the shapes of the crutch.
Improvise some of the shapes that make
the
hilt
way down
to make it look unique.
Say interesting.
All the way down to crutch.
And then successful we're going to be at that.
And then I think it's looking a lot better than these ones right here at this point.
There's one, three. Two, three, four. There's one tiny one here.
Hopefully, having learned what we learned from this thing.
Then the arm. Biceps, triceps, brachialis. That's a new one that I didn't know even existed. Sort of thing you keep on seeing over and over again, but you never learn it.
If we forget the thumb.
Biceps are these two muscles here. They are two. They are two, remember
suggestion
that. Another
thumb.
One. They are two muscles, and in really ripped ass.
Sometimes
people,
you can look at your own hand.
You can
see if you're doing it right.
The division between the two.
I think it's right.
I like to make the knuckles like a
little
spheres,
so that later on I can just
is this one.
Add the suggestion of the knuckle over
barak. Bicep.
Now you see how of all these muscles, the only ones that really stand out is the brachialis and brachio. No, the brachio. The brachioradialis.
One, I think. It's just one.
But after that one,
and then there's like a.
The brachialis doesn't really stand out that much. I don't.
Are we even going to use this?
Same here.
Where is she going to be?
See how the brachiodralgada?
Down here.
Goes all the way.
We need a filter now.
Out of all the other muscles. All the other muscles sort of fade away as you start adding the skin over.
We're gonna draw the arm, the other arm here.
Oh. Here we go again. Here's a suggestion. Suggestion. Suggestion.
We're gonna. The brachialis is right here. Right here's the brachialis. But out of these ones,
I should learn how to use
bunch
more brushes.
Tiny
now you see this hand is a little bit bigger than the other one.
The
we might have to fix that later. Should probably fix it now, but we won't.
The
alright, belly button.
Barak.
Her armor is gonna have a belly
Alice. And there are one
already
two,
decided.
Three, a bunch of them. And wrist. No, this one's just one. This one, the brachioradialis. And that's one
oh,
of
we're
the
drawing
muscles you can actually
these things right here.
Person.
It's better to do it from the center,
all the way from the
outwards.
Upper arm to the forearm,
I think.
Or where the wherever the, like
really
the shadow
out.
Is.
Really stands out.
You have to draw that like this.
Don't even have to flex. Now the wrist extensors.
What else? What else?
Don't really show up at all.
So the legs.
I think they're most of the time completely hidden within your flesh.
Almost done with the line art.
We're gonna try to fix this later. Excellent.
The only muscle here.
Excellent.
Is the
brachioradialis. Brach. Which is this one.
Single stroke.
Goes right.
Single stroke.
Look at it in your own flesh. I think.
Alright, this one it's gonna get tricky. With all of this garbage with the horse. I'm gonna do it.
Alright. Which, if you are like me, you hate drawing. We draw the knuckles. I've always been bad, really bad at drawing hands, so if you wanna ignore this part, feel free to go ahead. But if you don't, you wanna be bad like me, you can try. Like this, we draw the knuckles and the tendons that go back as guides. All of this is gonna be one big guide. We're going to paint over all of this, and you don't always have to do it, but we're doing it so that you can learn how I do it. Since this is has a little bit of perspective, we're drawing it inwards. Inwards. And here, the brachioradialis. The brachioradialis. Don't learn the muscles you already know. I mean, everybody knows where the biceps are, where the chest muscles are, where the shoulder are. Learn the muscles that you don't know where they are, because those are the ones that are gonna help you piece everything right together. Unlike me, who hasn't learned. We're gonna draw the brachial.
The saddle again. Made of
brachialis
leather or something along those lines.
This one, the brachialis, in between the biceps and the triceps, the brachialis. This is the ticket. This
I
is the one we're gonna learn today.
Again.
The brachialis and the brachia.
Goes all the way down.
Brachioradialis. The two, and they make a team. They make a little team. You see how they're together? They merge here. And then it goes like a snake and curls all the way. It goes below the arm, I think.
Alright.
It looks like. Maybe.
I think it does. I think it does.
We're gonna have to look for more reference. Because you see, here you can see the brachialis right here. And the brachioradialis right here. It goes all the way here, but I'm not sure if it comes, if it's this one and the other right here, can you see it? This one is one of these ones, I think, but I'm not sure, probably not, probably it stays on the other side of the arm. Anyway, so far this is looking good, I think.
It's
good.
Alright,
thin lines inside, it's gonna be a shame when you start
edges.
Removing all of them. Here is a little band. A little band that separates all this. And the what's it called? This little bone. Oh, we should have bone ruby structure for the next one.
This is really fancy,
fun,
exotic sword, magical.
So right now, we're only doing muscles, but what are muscles without any structure at all? They're nothing. Alright, here we're gonna draw the wrist extensors.
I feel like the eyes might be a little bit too big.
Here's the Brachioradialis with his friend the Brachia.
The chin a little bit too prominent.
One day I have to learn what this means. That's probably
starting to look weird.
Would make it a lot easier.
Don't worry, don't worry. There's nothing.
Probably means something like the muscle between the bicep and the triceps. Stupid Romans.
Now we start to make some stuff up with all the gibberish that we draw.
Brachioradialis goes all the way.
I'll make it clear. I think like a little snake.
Like a little snake.
Does that look like it would fit inside a closet? It's a one-handed sword, apparently.
The extensor here. One extensor. This one's a big one. There should probably only be one.
Next to the Brachioradialis, there's another.
No, I messed it up. I drew it wrong. This one's the Brachioradialis.
We're starting random stuff.
Brachioradialis, I think. Is that right? Brachioradialis. Brachioradialis. And then, next to that one is the Brachialis. Sounds like a fish. Brachialis. It's here, right here. Almost hidden. With the biceps, which are two. And the muscle, which
little
joins right between the brachialis and the biceps. Alright, and the trapezius. We're going to detail the trapezius later today. Later today, we're going to detail the trapezius. One second, we have some messages.
Fill all of this up to get it ready for coloring. We use the star select.
Look at all those cute little muscles.
We'll expand it a few, 3 pixels, so that we can invert it and then just fill the layer below with white.
No, extend wrist. Knit.
Extensors. Looks knit.
Where is it?
But it also shows us where we need to add a few extra lines.
One second. Where is our buff man?
The crutch lines.
Where is our buff man? Oh, this one's super good. This one's great. I'm gonna paste it.
Now we take this. We copy it.
Yeah. One,
we
two,
paste it here.
3, 4, 5, 6. See? It's different.
And final touch.
It's different.
We blur it a ton.
Everywhere
blur, Gaussian blur. That should help us see better where we need to render more or less.
Everywhere it's different.
And let's just start playing a little bit.
3, 4, 5.
Alright, sounds like food's ready. So let's take a little break. 1, 2.
We have a little bit of shadow below the neck.
So annoying.
I should probably do the line art of the armor properly.
1, 2, 3, 4. At least that one's consistent.
Alright, let's try something.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
We're going to add the sketch to the workflow.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright.
The question is, how are we going to do that?
Alright, let's take a little break. We need to fit the belly.
Alright. We're going to duplicate. We're going to put all of this into another folder.
Thanks for watching.
All the sketchwork.
I'm going to be back with this lesson.
We're going to duplicate it
after
and merge it all together.
Whoa,
now this is the sketch.
1 hour already.
So,
alright.
Bye bye.
I'm going to keep the stream online in case anyone stops by.
That, as we mentioned before, should help us guide the rendering. There we go. No. There we go. Now we're slowly paint over it all, but we're going to make a duplicate of the sketch layer, put it on top and turn it off. And every time we want to see where we're screwing anything up, we're gonna turn it back on. All right. There we go. Now this is just gonna go slow and steady, slow and steady. We might need to do this with a line art layer as well later on. We want to get rid of the line art. If we want to get rid of the line art, we'll decide that later. I'm gonna put some highlights based on this color right here. This is gonna be a badass armor with a muscle motif to accentuate the human physique. It's gonna look kind of sci-fi, cyborgish. It's gonna look pretty cool. What the heck is this? Should I give her an armor cleavage? Nah. We start adding highlights over all the... a lot of the edges, not all of them, but a lot of them. We don't have to worry too much about losing track of the muscles because we can always turn the other layer on again, the liner layer on top again. So we can just go crazy. it's looking neat. We're gonna use a darker color here to try and make some more contrast below the boobies. The armor, the booby armor. Not so much contrast. We don't wanna lose track of the Serratus after all the trouble we went through drawing it, painting it, counting it. Alright. Alright, we go from, as I mentioned before, each of these highlights, you can put them on the edges as they reflect any lighting from the edges that may come. But you can also put them on the center of the muscles. For example, here, on the center of each serratus, we put a little highlight to prepare for later. I already did it here, as you can see, but I can already also place a little bit highlight where each muscle meets each other muscle. Here we can go the center of each muscle, of each plate, armor plate, the center of the knuckles, the center of the other knuckle thing is here. The center of the tendons. The center of the abs. And then we slowly render away. I make a really soft brush. Now you might be wondering what kind of brush I'm using. I use the normal hard or soft brush. I adjust the hardness depending on what I want to do, but I have the pressure, the opacity and flow set to pressure. I also have, let me check, the size jitter, the angle jitter, and the roundness jitter set to pen pressure. See how it's all jerky? It adds I think a likable texture. I also have the dual brush set to some random parameters. I'm not really sure what I'm doing with this brush, but it's really, you can do it with however you want. Mostly what is most important is having opacity and flow. To me, the most important thing is having opacity and flow to pressure, and the angle, and no, it's really just the opacity and flow. Everything else is up to you. I also have the transfer on, and that is which it lets you, oh, let me put flow to opacity. Look at me lying to you. Another highlight in the middle of the muscle, of the armor muscle. It's looking good, it's looking good, I think. All of that time starting the muscle anatomy, starting to pay off. Now I'm gonna make it so that this armor goes all the way across the boobies. So it's not a breast titty plate. Might need to make it darker again later on, so these highlights are a bit too strong. We're gonna add some environmental lighting later on to bring the contrast up. I'll show you what I mean later. Well, you see, it's all rinse and repeat. You place your highlight and you start fading it out as you go. Electrified my golden tooth. All right, starting to come along. Gonna darken the eye a little bit. I can pick then the colors of the old one to a little bit of highlight. Gonna pick a darker color even to make an even stronger shadow. Now here I make a little triangle because of the nose, as you can see it. And I shade all of this because of the bridge of the nose. I have another triangle because of the because of the lips. And we're going to fade all of these ones out accordingly later on. Right now it looks too dark. Give it even deeper shadow. Start experimenting with the shadow here. We turn off the shadow we just made for a little bit so that we can go back to this and start rendering it. You don't really have to follow any step by step. These are just sort of, as you can see, I go back and forth. Just keep everything in different layers in case you want to change something later on.
magic armor, magic flesh armor. I forgot what these muscles are called. That's why we have to do it over and over again until we learn them. Why? Because we have nothing better to do. Since we already lost a little bit track of what the other muscles were, we turn this one back up. Right, we're still good. So it's gonna be the it looks neat. Well, it's not exactly very armor looking. Looks way too sci-fi. Gonna do the neck too, I think. Hopefully by the end of all of these, it'll look better than the old one. Alright, I think I'm gonna call it a day because I have to get to work. Thank you everyone for watching. Have a lovely evening and join me the next time of Darkly White Paints some random stuff. Bye-bye.
Alright, thanks for watching, everybody. Please check out my social media thingies.